friends, I hope I'm audible and visible. Please give me a quick thumbs up and welcome to the next session of Let's Crack Neet PG with me, Dr. Cheshta Agarwal, your dermatology educator on an academy. Now, I have myself scored All India Rank 261 in my entrance examination, and I will help you with the same in your cracking your exam. Now, you all are on the best online platform of an academy, that is, you are on the best online platform for the preparation of Neet PG, that is an academy. Download the Unacademy learning app from the App Store. Choose your category, which is Neet PG. Now, once you choose your category, you will see that there are two stuffs available on the platform. One is free and another is paid. Now, the free things which are present are a vast question bank of around 34,000 questions. They are available absolutely free. And second, we have live special classes. If you want to have an access to both Unacademy questions and special classes, you can use a welcome code, and that is Dr. Cheshta YT. And if you like any of them, you can use the paid subscription, which is Plus or Iconic. Now, Plus subscription gives you an access to Unacademy, live courses, live classes, structured courses, live test, and unlimited access to the platform. While Iconic give you the live classes of Unacademy, as well as it give you the recorded session of the prep ladder along with the question bank and rapid revision sessions. In addition to this, Iconic includes the study planner, the study material, expert guidelines, test analysis, and personal guidance. I request each and every one of you to please become an Unacademy Iconic subscription. You can use the referral code Dr. Cheshta YT for additional 10% discount on the subscription fees. And the best subscription would be for 1 year. If you want to take it for longer duration, the per month cost will reduce. And we also have no cost EMI options available on the platform. Similarly, you also can get Plus subscriptions with shorter duration of 3 months, 6 months, and longer duration, the per month cost reduce. Using Dr. Cheshta YT will give you additional 10% discount on the subscription fees. We are currently going on with a 3 plus 1 scheme, that if you buy a 3-month subscription of an academy, 1 month is free. And similar to this, if you buy a 12-month plus subscription, you will have 2 month free. Using the referral code, Dr. Cheshta YT will give you additional 10% discount. So please remember the code, that is Dr. Cheshta YT. Now we have the grand test, we have a free grand test series is every Sunday. Now the first was done on 13th of June and we have few more on 20th on 27th. The timings and the type of exams is given here, so I request all of you to please attend all the grand tests, which are absolutely free for you. We have many new batch courses which have started recently on 16th, that is a Neet PG session batch course, the Target Next batch course, the MBBS Professional Year batch course 1, 3 and MBBS Professional Year batch course number 3. So I request each and every one of you to please become a part of it. Okay. Now starting with the food and fruit as well as animal eponyms, very important to remember. Starting with the donut sign. What is donut sign? In a patient of scleromyxedema, you see deposition of mucin in the skin, and whenever you have deposition of mucin, you can see that there is infiltration of the skin over the knuckles. Can you see this infiltration over the knuckle? And this infiltration gives you an appearance like that of a donut. So donut sign is a specific feature of scleromyxedema, the first eponym of the today's session. It is a fruit or food eponym. Second is the puty orange appearance. Have you ever seen this? So puty orange appearance is a characteristic feature whenever you have obstruction of the dermal lymphatics. You can see that whenever the dermal lymphatics get obstructed, you will have multiple dips and the skin resemble the skin of a orange. This is a feature of carcinoma, pre-tibial myxedema, and even seen in a patient of rosacea. The puty orange appearance occurs because of involvement of the dermal lymphatics. Next is spaghetti and meatball. I think everybody have eat or everybody have seen that. You can also remember it as Manchurian with noodles or spaghetti and meatball, or you can remember it as banana or grape appearance. Now you can see that in Pityriasis versicolor, the hyphae and the spores, they are grouped together and they will give you an appearance which is called as spaghetti and meatball appearance. Very, very characteristic KOH finding in a patient of Pityriasis versicolor. And what is the causative agent? It is Melassezia furfur. The causative agent is Melassezia furfur for spaghetti and meatball appearance. Even Melassezia globosa is the causative agent for Pityriasis versicolor, where you have presence of both spores as well as the hyphae, giving it a noodles and a cheese ball appearance. Coming to the strawberry gums, I hope you have seen a strawberry and look at the image which is present on the right hand side. The gums give you an appearance like that of strawberry. So this strawberry gums is a characteristic feature of small vessel vasculitis called as Wegener's granulomatosis, which presents classically with a triad of upper respiratory tract, lower respiratory tract involvement and presence of small vessel vasculitis or the glomerulonephritis. So these are the important features of strawberry gums. Similar to strawberry gums, we have strawberry cervix in the patients of trichomoniasis, and we have strawberry tongue, which is seen in the patients of Kawasaki syndrome, also seen in patients of scarlet fever. So please remember, the strawberry term is very, very frequently used in dermatology: strawberry gums, strawberry cervix, strawberry tongue. Coming to the another fruit and food eponym, that is champagne bottle appearance. So please look at this image. You can see that the changes in the lower limb resemble that of a inverted champagne bottle appearance. So this champagne bottle appearance is seen in the patient of lipodermatosclerosis, and lipodermatosclerosis is seen in the patients of varicose vein. Seen in the patients of varicose vein very, very frequently. Now what happens, because of abnormality, the blood is not, the blood do not circulate back to the heart. It comes out of the blood vessel, start getting deposited in the skin, giving rise to sclerosis, thickening or fibrosis of the skin, and this appearance gives you an appearance of champagne bottle or inverted champagne bottle appearance. The next is the port wine stain. So have you seen a wine? Please remember, the port wine stain, the color resembles that of the wine, and this is one of the component of a syndrome which is called as Sturge-Weber syndrome. What is port wine stain? It is nothing but capillary malformation. Please remember, it is nothing but a capillary malformation, and this is one of the manifestation or one of the presentation of Sturge-Weber syndrome, which includes presence of glaucoma, presence of epilepsy along with the port wine stain over the face. I hope this is clear, Vaishnavi, Apurva and Maria, everyone. What is the port wine stain? Coming to the next part, sausage fingers. I hope you have seen sausages. They look somewhat like this. In a patient of psoriatic arthritis, you tend to develop the dactylitis as one of the features, and whenever there is associated dactylitis or inflammation of the small digits along with the involvement of DIP or distal interphalangeal joint, you will have a feature which is called as sausage finger. And can anybody tell me, if you take an x-ray, what will be the classical x-ray appearance of a psoriatic arthritis of hand? Anyone can tell me the answer? Vaishnavi, Apurva, anybody can tell me the answer? Please remember, if you take an x-ray, you will see something called as pencil in cup deformity. You will have something called as pencil in cup deformity. Okay, so these are the feature of psoriatic arthritis involvement of the digit called as sausage finger. Coming to the next, that is watermelon stomach. Now, why the watermelon stomach name given to it? I hope you all have seen that a watermelon, which is very, very common nowadays, you have a green color watermelon with white color stripes present over them. I hope you have seen the watermelon very, very frequently seen nowadays. It's a season for watermelon. Now, when you do the upper GI endoscopy or gastric endoscopy in a patient of systemic sclerosis, you will see presence of gastric enteral vascular ectasia, GEV. And this gastric enteral vascular ectasia will give you an appearance like that of watermelon, and that is why this stripe appearance is called as watermelon stomach in a patient of systemic sclerosis. And it is mainly seen in a patient of diffuse or progressive systemic sclerosis. Very nice, all of you, watermelon stomach. Now, Swiss cheese appearance. Have you seen a Swiss cheese? You might have seen in your childhood Tom and Jerry. I think a very, very popular cartoon characters. So the Jerry was, Jerry used to take or used to eat these type of cheese. And these cheese with multiple holes are called as Swiss cheese. Now, why this appearance is compared in a patient of borderline tuberculosis? Because in borderline tuberculosis, you will have multiple lesions. And these lesions will have a punched out appearance. Can you see this female? Just compare this female's back and the Swiss cheese. I think it becomes very easy. You can see that this is a Swiss cheese like punched out lesion. You have a punched out lesion here. You have a punched out lesion here. There you have a big punched out lesion. So this is somewhat resembling that of a Swiss cheese, characteristic feature of B.B. Hansen. Very, very characteristic feature of B.B. Hansen, that is the Swiss cheese pattern, also called as inverted saucer shape appearance. Characteristic feature of borderline leprosy. Coming to the next part, breakfast, lunch, dinner sign. Can anybody tell me where do you see this breakfast, lunch, dinner sign? Anybody can tell me the answer of this question. Where do you see breakfast, lunch, dinner sign? This is a feature of insect bite hypersensitivity or bed bug hypersensitivity. Please remember, it is a characteristic feature of breakfast, lunch, dinner is a feature of bed bug hypersensitivity or Cuttmull dermatitis, which is seen frequently over or when the patient uses the same bed which has not washed for a longer duration. Now, in these lesions, in these individuals, you will see that there are three lesions, three consecutive papules. Everywhere you have three consecutive papules, and these consecutive papules are thought to be the lesions of the bed bug bite. And it is thought that the bed bug have done its breakfast, lunch and dinner all together, and now he'll go and rest again in the beddings or clothings. So breakfast, lunch, dinner sign, very, very characteristic feature of bed bug hypersensitivity. The cat tongue sign, we have discussed this yesterday only or today itself. The cat tongue sign is nothing but another name for carpet tech sign, which is seen in the patients of DLE. And why it is seen? Because the scales have projection inside the follicular opening. So when these scales are removed, you will see the fine projections underneath these scales called as cat tongue or carpet tech sign. Now another sign or appearance is chicken skin or Moroccan's leather appearance. Everybody have seen a chicken skin, I guess. Or you have seen a leather. So this is how a Moroccan leather or chicken skin look like. And if you compare it with that of this image, this is the image of neck of a patient of pseudoxanthoma elasticum. I hope both these images are comparable. So in the patients of pseudoxanthoma elasticum, which is ABCC6 defect, in the patients of pseudoxanthoma elasticum where you have ABCC6 defect, you will have presence of multiple loses or loose skin or elastotic skin where the elasticity has lost, and it will give you an appearance like that of a chicken skin or Moroccan leather, feature of pseudoxanthoma elasticum. Coming to the next part, that is fish-like scale, and everybody know that the fish-like scale is a feature of ichthyosiform disorder. Ichthyosiform disorder, this is the feature of fish-like scales, is a feature of ichthyosiform disorders, which occurs because of abnormal keratinization of skin or abnormal or altered erythropoiesis. So all these together are called, or they resemble, these groups is called as ichthyosiform disorder. You have fish-like scales. Then is leonine facies. I hope you remember this word, leonine facies. It is a feature of lepromatous leprosy. Lepromatous leprosy, leonine facies, because of diffuse involvement of the face in a patient of lepromatous leprosy, you will see the face resembling that of a lion. I hope you can see this. So these wrinkles, big folds, they resemble the wrinkles and fold of the lion's face, and that is why it is called as leonine facies. The very important or frequently asked question that leonine facies is a characteristic feature of, answer is lepromatous leprosy. The next is lobster claw. Have you ever seen a lobster? In lobster, you have only two or three digits. You have few digits somewhat like this. Please remember, in ectodermal dysplasias, you can develop abnormal formation of the digits, and that is called as lobster claw deformity. Very, very characteristic of a syndrome called as EEC syndrome, where E is for ectrodactyly. Ectrodactyly means somewhat like this. Another E is for ectodermal dysplasia. And C stands for the cleft palate. So please remember, ectrodactyly, ectodermal dysplasia with cleft palate, it is a characteristic feature of lobster claw or EEC syndrome. Very nice, all of you. Coming to the next part, the moth-eaten alopecia. Where do you see the moth-eaten alopecia? Moth-eaten means as if some insect have bitten, or when a large crops, they are lost because of the damage by the insect. So you can see in a patient of secondary syphilis, you have multiple areas where there is loss of hairs. Can you see these areas? Multiple area where you have loss of hair. In a lot of patients, these are the scarring type of alopecia. And remember everyone, this is a classical case of secondary syphilis. The moth-eaten type of alopecia, which is the scarring type of alopecia. And the next is raccoon's eye. Again, this we have discussed in the morning, that raccoon's eye, whenever you have erythematous plaque present around the eyes or in the periocular region, feature of multiple diseases, like the first very important is neonatal LE. Also can be seen in primary systemic amyloidosis. And it can also be seen in the patients of frontal cranial fossa damage, okay, fracture. So please remember that you have raccoon's eye or owl's eye. The next is school of fish appearance, which is the characteristic feature of chancroid. So when you do the gram stain from the lesions of chancroid, you will see that the Haemophilus ducreyi, they are always arranged in group somewhat like this. Can you see? This is water, and inside the water you have grouping of the fish. So this appearance is called as school of fish, as if all the fish, they are together in their school. So please remember, school of fish appearance is a very characteristic feature of Haemophilus ducreyi or the causative agent in chancroid. Next is the toad skin. Toad skin is a feature of Phrynoderma. And Phrynoderma occurs most frequently because of vitamin A deficiency. Even it is seen secondary to essential fatty acids deficiency. And the skin resembles somewhat like this. Can you see here? There are multiple pointed papules. And this is how a toad skin look like. So resembling a toad skin, and that is why labeled as toad skin or Phrynoderma. Next is tiger tail appearance. Can you see the tiger tail here? You have alternate bend of light and dark. And here also you can see that under the polarized light, you can see the alternate band. This is a feature of trichothiodermia. dystrophy, which is nothing but a nucleotide or nucleotide excision repair disorder, where you have abnormal disulfide bonds in the hair, giving it a alternate dark and light patches when you look it under the polarized light. So this is called as tiger tail appearance. With this, we are done with the today's session. I hope everybody have enjoyed. If you like this class, please give me a thumbs up at the end. You can also write in the comment section if anything you want to discuss. Please subscribe to this YouTube channel, that is Let's Crack Neet PG. You can even follow me on my Telegram group, that is Let's Crack Neet PG. If you want to subscribe, use the code CHESHTA10 or Dr. CHESHTAYT. And please don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of all my classes. Bye bye.